Hello, hello, everybody. This is GrimYaz bringing you Blues and Bullets. This is an adventure game that is about Eliot Ness, who was a prohibition agent during the prohibition era, and who led a group called the Untouchables. If you don't know who those people were, they were basically agents that went after Al Capone, one of the most dangerous gangsters ever. And this game is about his retirement years. He's basically pulled back into the life again of being a detective. Well, yeah, he's more like a detective now, who wants to lead a peaceful life, but is hired by Al Capone this time for a special job. Now, this takes in a bit of an alternate universe type of deal, but it should be interesting. It is episodic, like Life is Strange and, you know, Telltale Games. So without further ado, let's get started. And there we go. I think there's 5 episodes, and I don't know when they'll be released, but I hope they'll be soon, because this looks really cool. The art style, the story, and everything else. Just look at it. It's noir style, obviously, you know. It looks pretty beautiful. And this is about to take a turn for the horror side, I think. Is it? It looks like it will. Where are we going? I don't want to go down there. It doesn't sound like a nice place. Just look at the art style, it's so amazing, it's so cool. I like it. I like it already. And also the fact that it has a little bit of horror going on. So what is that warlock wannabe douchebag doing with those kids? I don't think I want to know. Yeah, this took a turn for, you know, the worse. And we're right in the smack dab of action already, it seems like. But I don't think we're playing as Eliot Ness right now. It can't be. Oh, hello. You have red shoes. That's so cool. What am I supposed to... Am I playing you?
Here, it's your turn.
To do what? Oh, okay. Try to escape from the cell. How do I do that? Oh, I'm guessing I'm gonna use the lockpick. What is that? I don't wanna know what's in that bucket. What's this rock? Oh, how many days I've been there, I'm guessing. Okay. So that's not good. I've been here for a while, apparently.
Get me out of here, please.
Okay, kid, I will. Oh, and I have red ribbons on, too. That's so cool. Alright, let's see how badass ninja we are.
If we don't escape, I'll be punished. I've been bad.
No, you did really good, actually. Confidence!
Keep watch.
Yeah. Wow!
Okay, what if we're caught?
This kid is talented!
See? One down. That just leaves yours and the one on the door. I'll be punished. I've been bad. I'll be punished. It's okay. Be quiet.
Yeah, kid. Calm down. I got badass ninja lockpicking skills. What is this place? Holy shit. I want to finish this segment now.
He heard you. Quick.
He heard me.
Get me out of here.
Quiet. Was I supposed to sneak? How do I sneak? Like, do I go slow? Very slow? Like this? Tippy toe. Come on. Oh, I think I'm gonna make it. I don't exactly know how to. I was only like Oh, that sucks.
Yes, quick.
Shore's coming. I'm gonna help the kid. I'm gonna help him.
Quick.
I'm gonna try to help the kid. Come on. I'm gonna be nice.
What are you doing? Help me, please.
I tried, but apparently the game didn't let me. Sorry, kid. Be quiet, okay? Don't turn me in. What nice horns you have there, Mr. Warlock? And a deer's head.
She's there!
What the hell, kid? And I helped him!
She's been really bad, hasn't she?
No, you've been bad. Damn, kid. Oh. Hey, come on now, that's a bit uncalled for. The knife? I'm only hiding in a closet now. Oh, you shouldn't have done that. I don't think. Yeah, you shouldn't have closed the door. I'm a captive. Yeah, I knew that much. Ooh. This is gonna be a nice song. Or apparently it's not gonna be a nice song. Okay, that was it. It was still good though, wasn't it? I liked it. So yeah, missing kids. That's where we're at. And this also takes place in a fictional city, Santa Esperanza. It's not Chicago, like, you know, Al Capone was in real life. Although it kind of looks like, where are the cops? One is going right there, game. I mean, you know. It looks like, you know, 1950s Chicago. Open 24 hours. Jeez. Is Elliot the one opening it for 24 hours? That kind of sucks for him.
Elliot?
Just a second.
And there's Eliot Ness. Hey, buddy.
Alice, I thought you were on the day shift. Pie?
Well, I just slipped out for a second. This arrived for you at the station.
Thanks. I'll put it in the back room, then I'll get you a slice of pie. Deal?
I'm kind of in a hurry. What kind?
Blueberry.
It's a deal.
Yum. I'm hungry now, thanks. Let's pick this up. Put the check on your desk. Department of the Interior. Huh. Pension agency. For Eliot Ness. Yay! Money! That's good. So I'm gonna put this on the desk. I love the art style, man. I'm really digging it.
But I earned it.
Yep, you did. Considering you went after one of the most dangerous gangsters ever, I would say you did.
Days, like a lot of us.
I think.
Hey, Ness, where's my burger? God damn it, Ness! You gotta be the slowest waiter in Santa Esperanza.
Hey, I was a prohibition agent, asshole. Sarcasm.
I guess so. The girls at Happy Dolls say you're more of the speedy type.
Nice.
I won't keep you waiting again.
Anyway, they catch the deadbeat robbing the pharmacy, but there's no proof, so they hand him over to me.
Elliot, seriously, I don't have much time.
Sorry, y'all. Jeez, hold on. Right, there we go, the pie. You seem like a nicer cop, so, you know. I'll give you this for free, I'm guessing.
Take your time. If Jenkins says anything, tell him it's my fault. And let him know that I'll continue to keep his agents waiting until he settles his tab.
I don't think I dare. But this is worth getting in trouble for.
To think, I didn't find my true calling until I was in my 50s.
This looks like a nice diner, so, you know, that's good. Prepared Dickens' order, so this is the burger that he wants. Can I spit in it?
And this time, go easy on the chili sauce. Gives me indigestion.
Oh, good to know. More sauce. Even more sauce, yes. Yes! More! Come up with more!
Okay, tell him, if you confess right now, I finish work on time and everybody's happy. If you don't, I have to work late. I get mad, and I have to rearrange your face.
You really said that?
There you go.
And listen to this, Ness. And then I say to him, the doctor will have to work late too, and it'll be your fault. He'll be mad. And when he's done fixing your mug, it'll be so ugly, you'll never get laid again.
He's saying, right?
Yeah, like a soprano. And you know what I did next, Ness?
What did you do? You probably
celebrated Happy Dolls. 10 minutes later, you walked out of there.
Yeah, what the hell do you know? Anyway, the important part is I rearranged the guy's face.
Even after he talked. Wow, what a douche read. Enjoy your heartburn, burger.
How much sauce did you put on this thing, you goddamn maniac?
Just enough to make sure you never come back here, Dickinson.
Yes.
Ah, screw you, Ness.
Who's that? Attend to the suspicious customer. Why is he suspicious? Just because he's fidgeting around like he wants to murder someone? No. What do you want, dude?
Your first time here, right? I like this job, you know? Not because I like serving coffee or food. This job is about understanding people, knowing what they want, what they need. You just have to keep your eyes open. The clothes, the haircut, a little movement, a hand clutching a knife. Don't even think about it. Not because of me. At most, I'd knock out a couple of your teeth before disarming you. The guys you should be worried about are the cops at the other table. They'd keep kicking you in the ribs long after you passed out. You'd be lucky to wake up in a hospital. The question is, what do I do with you now?
Genius idea! Going to a diner filled with cops armed with a knife to try and rob it. I'm gonna be nice to you because you're dumb as a ball sack, and, you know, I'm a nice guy.
Buy yourself a suit, son.
Yeah.
Get a shave, get a job, and make a man of yourself. And if you come back here looking for trouble, you'll find it.
Nice, Ness. Like a boss. He still got it. Gratitude, I guess.
I forgot to thank you for bringing my pension check.
Well, I saved you a trip.
And a headache. The station's full of Dickinsons. Your dad would be proud of you.
Thanks. But not Jenkins.
Okay. Sounds like there's a story there.
Easy there, miss. Slow and steady wins the race.
Okay.
If I don't get some blackberry pie this minute, I'm gonna die before this day is out. Can you help me, sir?
I have blueberry.
I'm not.
That's too bad. I need something sweet for my last day on Earth.
Blueberry pie? Last slice.
You use almond extract?
Quarter of a teaspoon.
Which brand?
I make my own.
Damn. And a badass chef, too. Nice.
Do I know you from someplace?
Me? No.
But
you do know my boss.
Okay. What does that bullet mean? I don't think it's anything good. Oh, is it flashback time? Ooh, yay. 20 years ago, wow. Oh, this was during the time of the Prohibition, then, I'm guessing. When Eliot Ness was actually going after Al Capone. Single bullets. Why do I have it? Why are you drunk, Eliot? What happened? Oh, this must be when his partners died by Al Capone.
Garrison, O'Reilly, DiPietro, Dockers.
Something similar to that actually happened.
Garrison, O'Reilly, DiPietro, Dockers.
I don't know if all his partners died. But
Garrison, O'Reilly, DiPietro,
I know,
Dockers.
Eliot, okay. I'm trying to say something. I think one of his partners did, I know that, but I'm not sure if all of them did. Really, DiPietro, Dockers. Why do you keep saying it to yourself?
You call your boss.
Yeah, that's a smart idea.
Can't even enjoy a quiet smoke.
Look, I get it. It's Christmas. You're lonely and you want to end it all. But Santa Esperanza is full of bridges. Why not throw yourself off one of them and leave me in peace?
You could at least try to talk to me.
That Eliot Ness is here. We're going to finish this thing once and for all.
Jeez, I don't get paid enough. Listen, you got it backwards. I'm not here to make my boss come out. I'm here to stop you getting in.
Wrong answer. Threaten.
I hope you asked Santa Claus for crutches. Because if you don't do what I say, they're going to be the perfect gift for you.
Maybe I could borrow a pair from your buddy, Dockers.
Oh.
I hear he's never going to need them again.
Oh, you did not just do that.
You shouldn't have brought that up.
Yep, you shouldn't have.
Oh, no? You going to cry now? Hey, come on. It's Christmas.
Punch him in the face with that bottle. No, use the bottle. Okay, well, that works too. Apparently.
At the front gate!
Oh. Shoot him!
It's Ness!
That's not good.
Put down your weapons. You'll get a fair trial.
I only have a revolver. Oh, that sucks. Oh, I can shoot. Hey! Headshot! Come on! Oh, come on! Okay, that was a terrible shooting. That's so cool! I got... Okay. I don't think this happened in real life, you know? I don't really think Eliot Ness went John Rambo on Al Capone's mansion. Hey, BF... Does that blow up? Oh, yes, it does. Oh, that's so cool! Like, the buildings blow up too. Oh, look! What a conveniently placed field truck right next to the pool! Thank you for doing that, whoever did it.
We need more men!
Oh, can I get the Tommy gun? How about the Tommy gun? D! Get it! Hey! Quick time events! Yay! Get the Tommy gun! I want it!
Yes!
I got a Tommy gun, bitches!
I think I hit him!
Yeah, dude! Can I actually die? I can't, wow. I thought I couldn't. I don't know why. But it's okay, I got a Tommy gun. I got a Tommy gun, it's okay, people. I'm just gonna go on a rampage here. I gotta be careful. Oh, come on! That's like... four 45 caliber bullets into his... goddamn chest cavity. That should be enough to kill him. Alright, I got... two more. You're reloading, so you die. Any more? Okay, there's... hey, no, don't run away! Do I have an infinite amount of bullets? I think I do! Yeah! I love this game! I love this game already! Best game ever! But I get to shoot people with a Tommy gun and knock shit over. That's awesome. You're dead. Nope, you're not hiding there. Knock on my Tommy gun! Is that it? I think that's it. Keep the Tommy gun. Damn, Ness. Hell yeah. Look at what I've created, people. Wow. Well, we just gave a new meaning to going Rambo. From now on, it's going to be called Going Eliot Ness on somebody's ass. Because that was really, really fucking awesome. Well, now I'm in Al Capone's house, I guess. Can I shoot stuff in here? I'm going to mess this place up. What can I look at? Well, I'm just guessing that's Al Capone when he was a kid. Look at him, he's so innocent. Totally not murderous and, you know, killer at all. You wanna, mention why you said, huh? or side or whatever. That piano music is so soothing.
Have any last words?
You come into my house?
Irony, why not?
The doorman was kind enough to let me in.
You kill my men.
Irony again.
No human beings mattered to you.
Would you kill an unarmed man? You? Eliot Ness?
Why not? Irony again. Yeah, why not?
You have my word. I'm not going to kill
Oh, nice. Burn.
Vittorio.
Okay, that's not good.
Are you gonna kill me in front of my son?
You're really gonna use your son like that? What an asshole.
That stain right there is all that's left of D'Annunzio. One of my best men. I told him to take care of the butcher on East Main. One of the jerks who've been screwing with me for months. We had to make an example of him. Send a message to the other storekeepers. D'Annunzio ripped out his guts and hung him up with the merchandise. But he did it while the butcher's daughter was watching. Fucking D'Annunzio. There are lines that cannot be crossed. We have to protect the innocence of children. Keep them far, far away from certain experiences.
Well, aren't you just Mother Teresa?
Tell him to go.
Vittorio stays. He's my son, not a storekeeper's child. If his father dies, at least let him know who to take his revenge on. But that's not gonna happen.
You want to protect him from that experience.
His hand's shaking. Booze turns men into cowards. You'll be like your father. Never drink. It's funny, huh? The White Knight of the Volstead Act gets liquored up to kill the king of bootleg booze.
That is actually funny. Let's show restraints.
Relax, son. Nobody's going to kill anybody. I'd love to introduce you to a girl your age, Vittorio. Her name is Claire Dockers, and she sings like an angel. You two would get along. 2 days ago, Claire's father caught up with yours in a warehouse. Your father was hitting innocent people, and that's not right. He told him to stop, but your father ignored him and pulled out a gun to shoot him. Claire's father was quicker. He drew his gun first and fired. But the bullet jammed.
Oh.
Your father killed Claire's father. In cold blood. He kicked him in the face so many times, not even Claire herself would have recognized him.
You'll never prove I killed Dockers.
I know. And that's why I'm here. But now I know I'm better than you. Your father is a murderer. And Claire hasn't stopped crying these last 2 days, all because of him. Never forget that, Vittorio.
Damn.
Hold it. Let him go.
Well, thanks.
Run, Ness, and forget I exist, or I'll have to report what you just did. And I do have witnesses. You hear me, Ness?
You got no proof. Shut up. That I killed, like, you know, 50 people. Back to the present. Yay! So that was a nice memory. Not really, but it was still pretty awesome.
That's some first-class pie. I appreciate it. Thank you, sir. My car is parked outside. If you could join me as soon as possible, I'll be doubly grateful.
No.
Gentlemen, I'm closing up.
Okay, maybe yes.
So early? What are you talking about, Ness?
Are you serious?
I know, right? Weren't we open 24 hours? Friendliness.
Sorry, guys, I have to close up. Today's meal is on the house.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, tomorrow's too, or I'm not coming.
Shut up!
Back. You got
I
that?
Don't want you to.
Whatever you say, Dickinson.
Class act. Totally not a douchebag at all. Are you happy about the heartburn I gave you, by the way? I hope you are. Well, I have a nice red tie. That's cool.
I should have loaded it into Docker's gun and shot Capone.
Well, Maybe
it would have jammed again. But one way or another, it would all be over.
Maybe you should have loaded it. You don't want to take the bullet? I think you should.
Maybe it would have jammed again.
Yes, Elliot, I know. It would all be over. Alright, you said this, so let's get out of here. What else is... Do I have to do anything else? Oh, what's this? Santa Esperanza News. Kills his family and flees. Tuesday, June 7th. This morning, Osmond Burke, the condemned rapist of Vermont and son of rich tycoon Jebediah Burke, killed his family in what seems to be a rage attack. That better not be the guy that was here before, was it? No, I don't think it was. It better not have been. What else should we look at? Hey, what about Dickens's tab? Suck it-ness. Well, I guess I kind of deserve that after, you know, completely making his bowels move into down his pants. You know. What's this board? Ooh, that's a lot of missing kids. I'm guessing it has to do with the demon wannabe summoners. You know, or I don't know what the hell they're doing, but it's obviously not something good. Let's go into this car. I'm sure this is not a trap at all. Food to dine for. That's very clever. I like that. What is this? Never follow a stranger. I'm going against the advice of the game. So, yeah.
At last, Mr. Ness. Please get in.
Where are we going?
Where are we going?
A place that's a little too fancy for a guy like you. But if it's any consolation, it's way too fancy for me.
Not really.
Please get in. I can't afford for you to catch a cold.
I'm fine where I am. Never follow a stranger, yep. We're doing that, though, so... I'm guessing we're gonna see Al Capone. The past catches up. Yes, it does. Yes, it does. This looks like a weird place. Is that a casino? Or... I don't know what that is, but that's pretty cool. Venice. I really don't think it's the city Venice, obviously. What is it, all the masks? Seriously? What is the masquerade wall or something?
We'll be going up in a couple of minutes. I'll wait for you in the cable car.
Okay.
Up where?
Get to the cable car. What is it with these masks? And why are you people so creepy? I think I saw like a demon feather mask or something here. Okay. Let's look at the receptionists. Okay. I'm guessing you like the tattoos, Ness. What? Share your thoughts with me. Come on, man. I thought we were friends.
Your forced landing in New Jersey almost cost the lives of over 100 passengers.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Nearly a fireball in midair. It would have burned down half the city.
And it almost did. Well, not really, but it really burned. Okay, these people are extremely creepy. I want to get out of here, because I have a feeling they're going to turn on me or something like that. See, this is why you build a ramp, people. And, you know, don't try to do that over the stairs. Sorry, buddy. That really sucks. What's this? Who's this guy?
Hey, Ryan. Ryan Hotels, the visionary who transformed the Hindenburg into the monument to aeronautical luxury it is today.
Okay, good to know. Random thought, but whatever. Ooh, Ben, can I get something? I wanna drink. Is it out of order? What? Why? I wanted a drink. Let's go. I'm disappointed now.
Okay, let's go.
Oh, this is totally not risky at all. I really don't want anything bad to happen to that cable car, because we're pretty high up. Seriously, that's a little freaky. I wouldn't want to be in that. No. And I'm guessing Elliot doesn't either. Let's admit it. Let's be friendly.
I like to keep my feet on the ground.
That makes two of us.
See, now we're bonding. Isn't this nice?
If you need a paper bag, I have one.
I'm Eliot Ness. I don't need a paper bag.
How high does this thing go?
Higher than the clouds.
Wow, okay. How the hell? It's called an airport, blimp. Go into it. Don't make me, like, use a cable car to get up to you. Because there's, like, lots of things that can go wrong with that, isn't there? And I'm guessing this is, like, Al Capone's private blimp. This is a fancy place. And again, people with the masks, what the hell? Go to reception desk. Does she have a mask on too? Because that's not very nice. Seriously, look at all these masks. Someone explain to me.
Afraid I can't come with you. Thanks for the pie.
You're welcome.
Welcome to the Grand Hindenburg Hotel.
And you have a mask too.
My name is Susan, and I'm glad to be of service. Your name, please?
Let's give a false name.
Mr. Untouchable.
Nice, very creative.
In that case, I suggest you try not to live up to your name if you want to make the most of your stay at the Hindenburg, Mr. Untouchable.
Oh,
and
great.
Now, how can I help you?
I'm here to see Mr. Capone.
There's no Mr. Capone here, Mr. Untouchable.
Right. Let's be cunning.
Listen, Susan, I know more than 60 aliases for Al Capone, so you have two options. One is to delay my appointment with him until I guess the right one, which he is not going to like. The other is to send me through and earn my eternal gratitude and his. Your call.
He's in the presidential suite. Top floor at the end of the red carpet.
Thank you, Susan.
Have a pleasant stay at the Grand Hindenburg Hotel, Mr. Untouchable.
I love that name. And Ness, that was so badass,
your
dude.
Your attention, please. The cable car to Santa Esperanza leaves in 3 minutes.
Okay, but why tell me this? Am I supposed to do anything with that cable car? What is all... Ooh, wow. Yeah, so...
Higher than the clouds.
So Hindenburg 2.0 better not happen while I'm in this place. Because that would be bad. Let's go up. Oh, I can sprint too. That's cool. I didn't know I could. I just gave it a try and he's finally, like, jogging.
Your attention, please. The cable car to Santa Esperanza leaves in 2 minutes.
That was a little too fast. That wasn't a full minute. You're lying to me, game. Look at him jog. Elliot, you're so cool. And that's the same dude. What's in the window? Oh, fireworks. Cool. Let's watch them.
I window cleaners up here deserve every cent they make.
I know, right? I wouldn't torture all the money in the world. Me neither, buddy. Jeez. Alright, what's in here? Automatic doors, cool. Cynical optimism or nostalgia? I'm gonna be nostalgic.
I don't remember the last time I did that.
Huh. Me neither. So, we're in the same boat, Elliot. It's okay. Can I get something from the vending machine this time, perhaps? Really?
Damn.
Really?
Come on!
I know, right? And that's 20 cents that I wasted on vending machines that have not worked. Seriously, Capone, get a vending machine that works, please. I'm sure you can afford one. And not only that, I mean... I think this is gonna be like a running gag in this game that vending machines never work. What's in here? Oh. Yeah, let's not disturb. Yeah, me too, Ness. That's my reaction too. Oh, the Hindenburg. And so one day, my magnificent flying wonder will purify this pagan city with the eternal fire. That's totally not creepy or disturbing at all. So yeah, he sounds like a nice guy. Wanting to, like, purify people with fire. Why does he have money, then? That's not good. A rich guy that has those ambitions? Yeah. I'm guessing he's gonna be like a central character in this story maybe later on. Who knows? Maybe he's behind those, you know, warlock wannabes. I don't know. Reach Capone's suite. Okay, well, where is it? Is it straight ahead of me? I think so. What happened here?
What happened here?
Nothing to worry about, my good man.
I think I should.
On the Hindenburg stays on the Hindenburg.
That's not cool. How about on the police?
I've never had problems with the police.
Oh, many a one, my good man. In fact, what I'm cleaning up is today's first problem.
Oh. So, you're killing cops. That's not cool, man. What about the law?
Are you saying the law doesn't apply here?
We're too high up, my good man. The law had always preferred to look down.
I'm sensing a little metaphor there, sir. And I kinda agree, to a certain extent.
How can you work in a place like this?
You don't want to know where I worked before this, my good man.
I actually don't, if this is the better things you've done. What is this? Hindenburg Japanese Garden. Oh, that looks pretty nice. Yeah, yeah. Wait, what is that guy doing? Is he knife throwing? You know that's kind of dangerous. Let's go check him out. Maybe make him mess up. That would be cool. No, don't do that, Elliot. Don't like, you know, cause someone to die. Hang on. Is this the guy? The amazing Sharla, King of Knives. Hmm. He doesn't look- oh, he does look like the picture, never mind. Yeah, that's kinda dangerous, you know. And not to you, to the person, you know, being thrown at.
Bravo!
Oh! Elliot! Why are you jackasses clapping that? Apparently they wanted to for someone to get hurt.
I'm sorry.
Or die. Apparently you made their day, but not his day, Elliot. That wasn't cool. And I'm guessing this is Capone's suite. Let's see what the job is. I'm guessing it has something to do with the kids. Or else they wouldn't have shown us that. What is in here?
If it wasn't for my habit of checking all possible exits when I walk into the lion's den, I'd be a dead man.
Good policy. But I don't really think we have that many places to run in this place, considering we're like, you know, 10 miles up in the air.
You should be rotting in jail.
That's exactly what I've been doing for the last 19 and a half years. You'll be surprised what a little good behavior can do for a person. You're not gonna ask me for my last words this time. I'm a lot closer to death than when I last saw you. As are you.
You're funny, Al.
Not close enough.
Nah, that was funny.
Close enough for who?
Both.
Are you sure we need to choose?
Look, I didn't ask you here to find out who's got the snappiest
comebacks. Yeah, because it's me, buddy.
I want to hire you.
What?
I require your services as a detective.
Irony.
You're so old, I don't know if you're senile or if you're joking.
Elliot, you're so awesome.
Look, Ness. My granddaughter Sophia has been kidnapped. When what happened to my son, Vittorio, I put her in a boarding school. She was entered under a false surname, Colombo. Nobody knows who she is.
Nobody?
Only Milton. The man who brought you here, I trust him completely. 2 days ago, a guy turned up at the boarding school. He introduced himself as Guido Colombo, the girl's uncle, and her new legal guardian. He said her parents had just died in a tragic automobile accident. He produced all the relevant papers, driver's license, the custody document supposedly made out by the father, the death certificates. He explained away the fact that the girl didn't know him, by saying he moved to Seattle before she was born.
Any clues?
Well, Sophia was wearing a blue dress with flowers that I personally ordered for her from Italy. She was also wearing white ballet shoes with daisies embroidered on them. As for the guy, the school principal said he was tall and slim, in his 50s. No particular accent. Black hair, no beard, no glasses. Well-dressed. Could be anyone. But I know he was hired by one of my old associates. Someone wants to finish me once and for all. Maybe they want control of what's left of my organization. Maybe they hate my guts.
How could they?
I thought I was the only one who still hated you after 20 years. What else have you got?
I got this. And I got you.
You got your heart.
Me. My place is at my diner. And your girl's not there.
Huh. So where should I be looking?
Mafia, yeah.
You're the biggest boss in the mafia. And by the looks of this place, you didn't lose everything. Why don't you ask one of your subordinates for help?
You don't listen, do you? The kidnapper was hired by one of my men. One of the people I trust.
So why me?
20 years ago, I pushed you to the edge. I bought your friends and killed the ones who couldn't be bought. I got you so obsessed with me that your wife ended up leaving you. When you had nothing left, you walked into my house, shot my bodyguards, and pointed a gun at me. You could have killed me.
Okay.
You chose to restrain yourself. You even gave my son a lecture on ethics. You're the only honest man I know.
I'll do it for her. For the little girl.
Not for you. For her.
I knew I got the right guy.
But I want something in return.
As you can see, I'm not short of money. Ask. I won't haggle.
Hmm. Donation, jail, or exile. He probably wouldn't go back in jail, even if he did. Like, he has, like, what, 2 years to live? Exile would do him actually better, so you know what? I'm gonna be an ass and make sure his money goes somewhere nice.
You give your entire fortune to the Santa Esperanza Hospice.
Yeah!
That won't be difficult. I've been donating to them for decades, and I don't need the money anymore. I don't give a damn what happens to me, Ness. You just save Sophia.
I will.
And you can start by investigating
Carlo Boccherini.
Nice.
How did you know?
Biggest forger in Santa Esperanza. Wouldn't surprise me if Sophia's so-called uncle's papers were made by him. Besides, he's been cursing your name ever since we put you in jail.
Hey, I treated him like a son.
After you killed his parents.
They were selling booze without my permission. Wait, you know where to find them?
I have a good contact at the station. A girl. Rookie. Straight arrow. Reliable.
A girl? You saying you trust her?
You are such a chauvinist. Do you trust me?
Deal?
Punch him. I don't know if it's a good idea to punch my new employer who looks like he could die from a gust of wind, but what the hell?
Deal.
Oh, you son of a bitch.
Don't tell me you didn't deserve
it. Keep Milton informed at all times, huh? You hear me?
Yeah, yeah.
I know you from somewhere.
Was that supposed to be a threat or something? I mean, most likely Milton was in prison as well. That's how he met Capone. Most likely. I don't know.
Yeah, you're not gonna ask me for my last words.
You should be right. I'm never going to help you.
Why me? I'm not asking you to help me.
I'm not a cowskill.
What's going on?
Not for you. For her.
Is he drunk again? Oh, I'm controlling him. Okay. Where are we going, Elliot?
This town has become a jungle. Where not even rats are safe.
Oh, okay.
Fight to steal the last scraps of dignity we have left. And those who should judge them prefer to squabble over their prey.
So
it wasn't always like this. Esperanza, I was born, it was a clean town.
What am I doing? Another shooting game.
Meant something to be a cop.
It's time for Call of Duty, ladies and gentlemen. Hang on. Headshot, come on, headshot him. You too. Oh, nice. Reload. I assume they're killing our memories of something? I don't know. Bad memories, die! Die, bad memories, die.
Everything I had, but in the end I sent it to hell.
Well, he got out. So that kinda sucks.
Rebuilt my life. Got my feet back on the ground. But now he's back. And he's dragged me in.
Just when I thought I was out, they'd pull me back in! Right, Elliot? That kind of stuff.
I'm gonna need help.
From who? How about orange juice instead? And, you know, let's not drink alcohol. I'm assuming you have a problem with that. Maybe I should answer. I can drink orange juice later. It'll still be there.
Ness.
Elliot, I found Carlo Boccherini.
I knew you would, Alice.
Write this down. 31 Wicker Avenue, in Lakeview.
Thanks. Nice work.
Elliot, what do you want with him? He's got a hell of a file.
I'm gonna tell the truth. I'm gonna be nice with
him. I think he's mixed up in a kidnapping, but my client doesn't want the police involved.
What are you getting yourself into? Who's your client?
Alice, I don't have much time. I'll let you know how it goes. Thanks. tomorrow's going to be a long, long day.
Well, we got our orange juice to help us. Come on, it'll be fine. Old enemy achievements. Yeah.
31 Wicker Avenue. This is it.
You sure?
I'm sure.
At last. That stench of stale grease about you reminds me too much of my old job.
What do you got against grease?
I smell of grease?
I don't think anyone else would notice. But when you spend a part of your sentence as a chef in the kitchens on Gore Island, you smell it a mile away. And how do you think I met Alphonse playing golf?
Alphonse.
Alphonse.
On the subject of cooking, I know your blueberry pie had an extra something. I still don't know what.
Alphonse.
So what now? You got a plan?
Take a look around in case there's a rear exit. I'll take the main door.
My pleasure.
Alright guys, I'm gonna cut it here. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!